Hi, what is up people? Today we are going to discuss a very important thing which is called as brand analytics, which is a feature which Amazon has released for everyone who is a brand registered seller, meaning a person who has a trademark and has registered its brand name with Amazon. You guys can use this cool feature. Now, before I get into this, I just want to request you, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel, hit that smash like button if you really like this video, and tell me after the video, what is your strategy? Have you ever been a brand registered seller? So let's begin with the video. So what is brand analytics? It's a tool which is given by Amazon, which tells you exactly what keywords people are literally typing, not the estimates, people are literally going to Amazon in typing that exact keyword and how much is that popular as compared to all the keywords across Amazon for like say 2 lakh keywords. Now let me tell you how and what and when, right? So where can you find this tool? Go in your reports, then go to brand analytics. Pretty cool, yeah. I'm really excited, guys, right? Or one more clarification, I'm going to make this video and my coming videos in English, meaning semi a lot of English and most of the Hindi, because a lot of crowd had come before to me saying that they want a lot of Hindi, but my Hindi is really not that good. So I would try to mix and match so that both audience can resonate. So bear with me if my Hindi is not that great. And dekhiye, ye hai Amazon brand analytics ka portal. Okay, and let's say now this exactly tells you, right? Jaise abhi humko dekhna hai ye week mein, okay, weekly we are seeing daily. Aaj on 25th yesterday kya cheez Amazon pe sabse zyada popular thi? Aap dekhi total rows dikha rahe 1,24,000. Matlab total 1,24,000 searches ho rahi hai Amazon mein daily. Ab ye pura nahi dikhate, ye actually searches ho sakti hai 10 15 20 lakh, but ye log sirf itna sa hi data dete jo really bahut popular hai Amazon par. To aap dekhoge sabse zyada abhi log kya type kar rahe hai Amazon pe, trimmer for men. Aap dekh sakte ho trimmer for men itna popular hai agar aapne ye literally start kiya. If you start this product right now, you are crushing it. I mean the top sales, like the highest sales are coming from the keyword trimmer for men. Now then second best popular term right now is mobile, then mask, trimmer, then laptop, rice, Dettol. So earphones, sanitizers, atta, cheese. So now you can find the trend, right? Okay, what exactly are people typing in right now in COVID? So you get an idea ke jab log online aa rahe hai during this COVID-19, this is crisis period, what exactly are people buying? What are the buyer trends? अभी सबसे ज़्यादा आपको मालूम पड़ रहा है, a lot of people may be thinking कि चलो यार COVID-19 है तो सबसे ज़्यादा लोग ग्रोसरी बाय कर रहे होंगे या घरों में रह रहे होंगे. But you will be shocked when you see this data कि trimmer for men is on the top. इसका मतलब आटा, दाल चावल, ये सब चीज़ें जो लास्ट लोग ट्रिमर सबसे ज़्यादा बाय कर रहे हैं, बिकॉज लोग अभी शेविंग कराने बाहर नहीं जा सकते एंड दे नीड टू लुक वेरी गुड. एंड ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द मेजर क्राइटेरिया इज अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल वॉन्ट टू नाउ गेट इन टू सोशल मीडिया. इफ यू सी टिकटॉक इज ग्रोइंग लाइक क्रेजी इन COVID-19, सो पीपल वॉन्ट टू मेक वीडियोज, एंड इफ दे आर बियर्ड एंड एवरीथिंग इज नॉट वेरी कूल एंड नॉट वेरी गुड, दे वुड वॉन्ट अ ट्रिमर टू ट्रीम इट वेरी वेल एंड एक्चुअली बाय अ ट्रिमर टू मेक योर सेल्फ लुक यू नो वेरी गुड प्रोफेशनल. This is one thing. This is something that you could actually understand. Now where can you use this, right? So you can see from daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly. Let's get back to monthly. Okay, let's see from let's say we are looking for before COVID, let's say in Jan. Okay, if I press in Jan, I come to know the most popular keyword during this month of Jan was shoes. Then you can remove this. This is something that I don't know what it is. Then saris were more popular. Watch. Now this gives you an indication of what is so popular products to sell on Amazon if you are a beginner or you just want to start selling a new product, right? Because you literally know that shoes sabse zyada sell hote hain Amazon pe. Second searchability is about saris. Aap dekho ye number 3 hai, matlab pure Amazon ke research search term mein the third best product which is selling in the month of Jan is sari, then is watches, then is smartphones. And now if you want to see a broader view, okay, ye chalo ye to monthly hoga, it can be something which is trending. Now let's see something which is quarterly. Okay, so you can go to quarterly and you can apply. let's say we are applying from say October till December, right? And now we are understanding shoes is still popular and the second best search term across Amazon in a 3 month period. Similar is a sari, watch, laptop. So if you're getting into shoes, it's amazing time to get into shoes on Amazon because it's the most searched product. But now this can be something which is very tricky. Shoes is a category where you get a lot of returns. So if you are a manufacturer and you're getting a lot of returns and you're okay with that, that's completely fine. But if you want to get into an item which is not that complicated, you need to avoid all these shoes, saris, mobiles, right, kurtis, because clothing, shoes has a lot of returns, but simultaneously they have a lot of volumes too. Now another interesting thing which Amazon has shown is, see, if you are shoes, selling shoes, now you want to know if it is a popular term as shoes, is it that Nike shoes are selling more or Adidas shoes are selling more, or is it something which is a generic item? So I can literally now, you know, see which keywords are converting for this product. So I can see shoes, right? And I can see this item has been clicked the most when somebody types a number shoes. So now I can actually see which item is this. And I have to go to the Amazon. Now I can literally see this is not a branded product, right? And this gets the most number of clicks when somebody types shoes. So this means this is the most popular shoes to sell under this keyword shoes, right? Now how is this data very valuable to you? You can actually see what this person is doing and replicate the same. First of all, you get the idea that this product is very popular for this keyword. Matlab koi shoes word dal raha hai to ye product bahut hi zyada bik raha hai. Now second, you can see the titles. What are they actually putting in the title? Because this is something which is converting. You can see the kind of images they are putting. You can see, okay, this kind of images are working well. They're doing something right, guys. Otherwise, they can't be the number one clicked ASIN for the so much, like such a popular term keyword. So you can see their title. You can see their images. You can see what kind of bullet points they are doing. Okay, what kind of reviews they have, which is very critical. And you can also see what price point they are selling. Right now, you can't see the price point because of the COVID-19, but I have this graph called as Keepa, which you can download. This is the extension. It's called Keepa. You can download a Chrome extension and it will show you the previous history of this. So now you can see it's a 419 product, 419 rupees. Now, how can you replicate the same? See, now there's a big opportunity. First of all, the titles are not very well optimized. So you can use these titles such as, you know, casual, walking, running, gym shoes, but you can also add other keywords, which I will show you in other couple of videos, how to find high converting keywords. Secondly, see, the bullet points are also very pathetic. They are not in a proper order. So you can obviously make a very well optimized listing. Generally, an image or an optimized listing should at least have 6 to 7 images, but you can see only 3 images are there. Big opportunity. Though the images are good, I wouldn't say it is bad, but you can add a couple of images to, you know, really sell this at a high volume. Now coming back to reviews, if you see reviews, 1065 reviews. Now at a glance, it looks like it is a lot of reviews, but really, if you see, they have 3-star reviews. It means there is a huge scope of improvement. It is a 3-star review. Literally, like, people are buying this because the design is so cool, but the reviews are pathetic. Iska matlab, if you bring a new product into the market with a better quality, you can literally, and like, you know, better images and really good bullet points and optimized title, you can make a killer listing, killer sales by just selling this generic shoes that doesn't even have to be a brand. See, this brand says it's a Lysa brand, but do you see anything which is of the mark Lysa? You really don't see. It's a simple Chinese product, right? So this is what you can do with this. And if you see further, this also shows you something which is very cool, right? We had seen the term shoes, right? Now see, in the shoes, this is the number one clicked ASIN that we had seen, but the conversion share is only 7.9%. Matlab, if somebody is typing shoes and they're clicking on this link, they are just getting 7.9% 9-3 conversion, which is pretty cool, I would say, because it's a widely searched term. And even if you make a conversion of 2-3%, it is pretty cool. Matlab, this is very, very popular as a keyword, right? Now, the second most click ASIN is this. Now, let's see this. This is another generic product, right? And if you see, they have 941 reviews. Similar pattern, you know, they have three images. Titles are very okay, not so great. Bullet points are not at all optimized and are not very clear. You can see they are selling it for 329. And the reviews are also 3-star. Again, a good opportunity to improve the product, and you can sell this, right? Another thing to notice is, now after this, this is the second most clicked ASIN, which is 5.11% and has a 6.27% click ratio. Matlab, koi aadmi ye product par aa raha hai, so he's clicking on that link and they're converting at 6.7%. Out of 100%, they're getting a market share of 6.27%, which is pretty cool. Like a listing with three images, not so popular, you know, titles, and the bullet points. This is a huge opportunity for you guys if you are looking at this, but you have to be very much you know, comfortable understanding the competition level, because we are just seeing the people who are converting very well. There may be other people who must be doing really well and they have a lot of reviews. So this is something that just gets you an idea of the products that you could actually start sourcing, right? So this is something that you could do. Now the second use that you could do is, you have to also understand that you don't have to go through a list of keywords which are brand dominated. Meaning, let's not go into laptop, because no one's going to buy a laptop which is not branded. Like, just see the number one clicked ASIN. It's Lenovo, right? No one's going to go and, you know, buy a private label item. But see the mobile. Mobile also is not a category that you should go in. Go start scrolling and go through the items which are very generic. Like, saris are generic. There's no a specific brand that is very popular and dominating the entire category. You can see the watch. Now let's say watch about. Now if you see watch, like, these are the normal watches, you know, like simple watches which is not even branded, and people are buying tons and tons of it. And if you see, the price points are very, very pathetic. It's 76, I mean 191. You shouldn't be selling these kind of products. Any item which is more than 500 rupees is something that will really give you profits. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense for you to actually go and start selling a very cheap product. You will not make any kind of money. So this is how you can actually use brand analytics. Also, I'll show you one cool feature to understand the product research. Let's say if I want to understand my competitor, this is my competitor, what kind of keywords is he converting for? Like top 4 or 5 keywords. Now I'll copy this. I'll go to brand analytics. I'll type the ASIN and I'll tell you apply. Now literally Amazon shows me this keyword is convert, like this ASIN, this product is converting for all these top keywords. Now what I can do, if I'm selling a watch, I can actually use these keywords in my Amazon PPC ads and run PPC on this and literally make a lot of money. This is like reverse searching your competitor. What is your upper competitor kaun hai? And what kind of keywords are they ranking for? So you know, I can target these keywords because they are already selling very well for my competitor. If I do a better job, I actually can use these keywords in the sponsor ads. And these keywords are literally from Amazon. Now you can see watch for boys is 94th popular term. Watch for boys under 200 is the most searched after the watch for boys. So these keywords are not available anywhere, and like, trust me guys, you can use these keywords because these keywords convert and they are directly from Amazon. These are not estimates like other tools. Another cool feature that you could do, let's say if you're selling watch, okay, you can just type watch over here and you'll get all the keywords that are related to watch. See, 67 keywords. Like, where can you get this data? You cannot get this data from anywhere. All these tools are estimates, but these are the perfect keywords which Amazon is telling you that buyers are coming on their platform and are literally typing. So this is pretty cool to reverse engineer your top competitors and what kind of keywords they are ranking. Also, without this, just by typing keywords, you will understand what kind of keywords that you can use for your PPC campaign. I have a lot and lot to share you about other cool features. You can see this repeat buyer purchase, market basket analysis, you know, comparison and other cool features that you can use brand analytics for, and also, you know, other types of category typing and ASIN targeting for your sponsored ads, which I'll cover in the next videos. I hope this video has got you some value and you can use this video literally for, you know, doing a lot of keyword research, your competitors, which products to sell. Also, be very careful that these keywords will also require a lot of further depth to understand what kind of products are actually very popular, but what is the competition level, that even if you can enter or you can't enter, right? So this is that you have to keep in your mind, and I'll see you in the next video. Just let me know in the comments if you're a brand registered seller and if you have been using brand analytics, and put your questions below and let me know what kind of more videos you want that could help you to boost your business. For now, this is it. I hope you guys got the value. If you really like the video, please smash a thumbs up, smash that subscribe button to get more valuable videos on how to sell on Amazon FBA. For now, I will say goodbye, God bless, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.